Most likely you are watching this video because your computer is running with an issue here as you are trying to open a program you have recently installed. This error arrived. The program can start because xapofx1_5.dll is missing from your computer. It's a somewhat critical error and all you need to do is watch this video patiently and follow that method on your computer. Hello everyone. Welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error within 3 minutes, so let's get started. Open your favorite browser and search for xapofx1_5.dll. You can choose any result you want. In this case, I'll be choosing the first one. This is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. Here you can see few download options based on the architecture and version. To know your architecture and version, click on start and search for system information. There you go. You can see mine is a 64-bit PC and I'm updated. So in this case, I'll be downloading the second one. I strongly recommend you to read this space. It has other fixing method also. As the download complete, hit open. You can see the DLL file in the downloaded zip. To move the DLL, first open this PC, then local disk Windows, and find a folder named system32. Basically, this is a folder where all the 32-bit DLL files are situated. Then click on the downloaded zip, drag the DLL and drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace. And click on continue to give administrator access. Before we go ahead, let's check. By typing the file name, you can see the file is placed, so the missing problem should be solved for 32-bit users. If you are a 64-bit users, open this PC one more time. Local disk Windows. And this time, find a folder named sys64. Basically, this is the home of 64-bit DLL files. And similarly, drag and drop. Basically, the 64-bit users need to place the file in both 32-bit folder and 64-bit folder. Check this one more time. Yeah, you can see the file is placed, so they can't say that we don't have the DLL in the folder. And finally, restart your computer. In extremely rare cases, if the error still occurs, you need to download and install latest Microsoft DirectX for Microsoft official website and install your program again, and that will surely fix it.
And that's all. If you follow me step by steps, you'll no longer have that problem left. Please let me know how you feel about this video. And do not forget to like and subscribe.